Hi and welcome, dear geospatial community. After 1 year forced break due to Corona, INTERGEO is back. Here's INTERGEO TV with news, interviews, innovations and highlights from the exhibition halls in Hannover. Finally, we meet live again and hybrid. That means you are live on the digital platform in the stream or you are currently visiting the EXPO halls here in Hannover. And the INTERGEO Conference here, of course, too. So no matter how you landed with us, we are glad to have you with us. So my name is Denise Wenzel and together with the INTERGEO communication team of reporters, producers and editors, we'll keep you up to date on what's going on here over the next 3 days. And especially the team around the INTERGEO project manager Daniel Katzer has made all this here possible again. So Daniel, great to have you here this morning in our INTERGEO TV news show. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Denise. Nice to see you.
So yes, I mean it's perfect. We're here again, and so how glad are you, or how big is your joy that finally we can meet in person here and with the exhibitors, the booths, and the visitors are coming in. So how do you feel?
It's crazy. After 2 years of lockdown we had, so we met 2019 in Stuttgart, right? And then we had this lockdown last year. It was terrible for all of us. And when I joined in this morning to this venue, to this hall, and I see so many laughing faces, right? Are keen, they are willing to meet in person, and not only digital, even we have the opportunity, as you said before, but they can meet in person, and that is something very astonishing for all of us.
Yeah, great. We just see some pictures from the setting up from yesterday.
Yeah,
we see Hexagon's booth.
There are a lot of nice booths, and the exhibitors, they are willing, they're pushing, showing some new instruments and products here on the show. They're showing it live. I can touch it, a little bit under hygiene concept, right? But they can touch it. I can see what's going on here.
That's really
and that's
great.
Something very special.
So, it was a tough year to all of us, especially to event organizers, but of course also to the industry and staying in contact with the industry, of course. So just describe us, how was that year, especially when it was long not clear if INTERGEO is really happening, so here in Hannover, or again in a digital edition. Just give us an overview how that was for you and the team.
Yeah, well, the very beginning we started from 2020 on was we are going hybrid. We plan to go hybrid. We have the digital platform ready, and we love to meet in person again. So all of us we had to organize two things, digital on the one side and physically on the other side. And you're right, we had at least 2 months before the show starts here today, we had the permission to go live in Riegl. So we had the opportunity, and we had a lot of meetings via Zoom and Teams and so on with our exhibitors, with our partners, to make this possible all in. And a lot of services has been asked about questions. How can I handle digital and physically parallel, as we are getting now see persons on site and we can see them online as well. So that was a tough work for us as well, but finally it works. We have more than 250 companies here on the ground. We have seen some pictures, and we will see some nice pictures, I believe, within the next 2 days. So yeah, it was a tough time, but we could make it happen, and that's the point.
That's really great. Yeah. And actually this works because here are concrete rules for hygiene measures, hygiene concept.
Yeah.
So just tell us about that. And we also have some pictures who will show how the testing works and how the concept here works with masks, because we are here in the show, are allowed to wear no masks. Usually this is the concept. Just take us with you into the rules.
Yeah. Well, we are inside the halls right now. And yes, one thing that is important within this concept is to wear a mask when I'm out of a booth. Unfortunately, I have to wear a mask on the booth as well, unless we can keep the distances like we are doing right now. But as everybody knows from INTERGEO, normally we talk within INTERGEO 3D, right, for 3D models, for instance.
But digital
twins, right, I can see it on the screen, and that's here in this concept of hygiene is 3G. That means even if I'm recovered or I have a vaccination, then I can pass in quite easily. It's quite easy to come in here. It will be checked at the entrances. And if I have not these other two Gs, then we have a testing center over there. I get within 15 minutes, 20 minutes, I get my test, negative test, and then I can pass in as well. So it's quite easy wearing the mask, keeping the distance. And I think that's something we normally do in the normal life currently, and we have learned within the last 2.5 years.
Yeah. Daniel, you just mentioned here are about over 250 exhibitors. Yeah. We have the EXPO stage where the program is full packed. Mm-hmm. We have the conference. And what are you looking forward to today, especially at this opening day of INTERGEO 2021?
Well, the thing is that I had the opportunity from Saturday on to see what's coming up. So within the setting times, and I lifted a little bit the curtain to see, okay, there are some new drones, there are some new instruments, here's some software parts, and I love to go around within the next 3 days to see what's coming more than this that I could see already within the setting up phase, and that's starting this morning. So I'm taking my trolley right now, and then I'm going through the aisles and ask the exhibitors what's new, and then I give you some notes about this as well. So it's quite new to see instruments here. We have Hexagon, for instance, launching a new product. Trimble is doing as well.
Yeah, we have them even here in the news.
Oh, really?
Today.
Okay,
I haven't seen it. We'll get to know what are the main highlights of Hexagon this year.
Drones, robotics, so there's something special and new in here. And I love to see it. And I love to see it here in person.
Mm. Actually, you could use the situation here. Who you want to say thank you, maybe partners or special good colleagues, or just use the stage to send your welcome message.
Okay, first of all, thanks to all partners that are joining us, even digital, even here in person, for sure, more in person, because I love, and we were gambling yesterday with some colleagues we met 2 years ago, unfortunately. And that's the one point, to the sponsors, for sure, to the whole team that make it possible at least, and for sure also to Deutsche Messe and the region of Hannover, Lower Saxonia, to make this hygiene concept ready so that we can be here today and within the next 3 days. And yes, I'm inviting all of them to come here, and even who can't, yes, join us on the digital platform. You find all information in here as well. You find the program, the stages, the conference in there within the stream, so you can follow up what is here making possible within this restarting of INTERGEO 2021.
Thank you very much, Daniel. It was a pleasure to have you here in our first edition of the INTERGEO TV News 2021. We wish you lots of fun here with the exhibition.
Thank you.
And I think we'll see you again within the next 3 days.
Thank you very much, Denise.
Thank you, Daniel.
Bye.
So, and as Daniel just mentioned, the exhibitors and partners are an important element in the INTERGEO success story. My colleague Helen Bayant met Frank Hoch from Aaron Data Software at the setup and wanted to know what the mood is like and how the preparations are going on.
Thank you, Denise. I'm here with Frank Hoch from the company RM Data Software. And yes, first of all, today is setup day. What's your first impressions of the exhibition halls?
We are very excited to be here in Hannover 2021 INTERGEO. So the journey was good. We're proud to be here and hope that we'll a great exhibition for us and for all the rest here. I think all of them are excited to be here after 2 years, so let's get started.
We can finally meet personally. How happy are you about this?
I think that's the main thing, to use INTERGEO to visit our customers, to meet our customers, to meet new people interested in our software. So after 2 years, always will be online web sessions or this stuff. We are proud and we are happy to be here. INTERGEO 2021 Hannover, very, very nice.
What are your hopes for the next few days?
Personally, meetings with our customers and to meet people interested in our software, 3D works or other CAD, all this stuff that 2 years have waited to do this, what we can do the next 3 days, so why not? And I hope many, many people come here to visit the exhibition, to visit our booth.
Thank you for your time.
Have a good time.
Back to you, Denise.
Thank you very much, Helen and Frank Hoch. So across the exhibition halls as well as the digital platform, the participating companies will be showcasing their innovations and solutions in the field of geodesy, geo-IT, building information modeling, drones and smart city. So with over 50, I guess there are 55 product releases, INTERGEO is once again the international showroom for world firsts. So before things got underway this morning, I spoke with Jürgen Nussbaum. He is director, international sales at Riegel Laser Measurement Systems. And of course, I wanted to know what new products does Riegel want to present this year at INTERGEO?
Yeah, in short, we have a number of new and innovative products in all Riegel segments.
Okay, that sounds like exciting developments at Riegel. Now let's go one level deeper. Let's go into your products worlds. So what is the situation specifically in your unmanned scanning and mobile scanning areas?
Yeah, for the unmanned laser scanning segment, we are presenting the new Mini VUX 1LR. Laser scanner with significantly increased range performance, as well as a new scanner out of the well-known VUX1 series. It is the VUX1 UAV Edition 22. And the key feature is it supports a pulse repetition rate of up to 1.2 megahertz now. In the MLS segment, we are presenting also a member out of this new 22 edition, the VUX1 HA LiDAR scanner engine with a pulse repetition rate of up to 1.8 megahertz. Yeah, for both of the segments, the ULS and the MLS, we are very happy to present a new platform, the VMY1, a single scanner system integrating scanners out of the Mini VUX1 series as an entry-level MLS system, where the integrated Mini Fuchs SUS, the core of the system, can be taken out easily of the VMY platform for operating it like a typical Mini VUX SUS from a UAV platform.
Exciting innovations, and an important segment of your company is airborne laser scanning. What is exactly new here?
Yeah, in the airborne laser segment, we are presenting also a new member out of the Edition 22. It is the well-known VUX1LR, now with a pulse repetition rate of up to 1.5 megahertz. Yeah, and as introduced already earlier this year, in the course of our first virtual conference day in May, we are also exhibiting at the booth the VQ780 Mark IIs, the high-performance single LiDAR scanner engine, which is in the meantime well acknowledged in the market. And now, the great news for ALS. We are introducing at INTERGEO, the new Riegel VQX1 wing pod for external mounting onto any Cessna aircraft of the 172, 182, and 206 series. Here we are. Yeah, the EASA certification is fully in progress. So it is the first time that we will be in a position then to offer a fully EASA-certified airborne laser scanning platform system solution based on this new Riegel VQX1 wing pod, which allows to integrate different Riegel airborne laser scanning system configuration, like with the VQ582 or the VQ840G topo hydrographic airborne LiDAR scanner, or even the a little smaller VUX 240 scanner.
Wow, this speaks for the fact that the VQX1 wing pod that you just mentioned makes life easier for surveyors. So do you also have similarly convenient solutions in store for terrestrial laser scanning?
Yes, indeed. Our very well-known VC400i scanners are already operated in the meantime with a number of well-known robotic platforms like the RoboDogs and others. But at INTERGEO, we are very happy to presenting our new and our first Riegel robotic platform for railway scanning. It is the new Riegel VMR. As you can see, the VMR is a robotic vehicle which can be operated on rail tracks. It is equipped with a VC400 I3D laser scanner for automatic surveying of specific railway segments in a stop-and-go mode with high resolution and accurate 3D scan data and image data acquisition.
Wow, so there are also great simplifications when it comes to recording specific segments of railway routes. So these were a lot of announcement and news, so please summarize once again what users of your solutions can expect from your innovations this year.
Yeah, so this year we are presenting not only a number of new products, but we also have a very strong focus on system solutions for our customers to acquire data as efficient and as convenient as possible. Absolutely new in this connection is our approach to offer a fully EASA certified wing pod for the different Cessna aircrafts, which will make life much easier for our customers, as they simply do not need to deal with exhausting and expensive airworthiness certification processes. They can simply install the VQX1 onto any existing Cessna aircraft out of these types without the need of any modification of the cabin. Yeah? Take it as it is in any country and simply install it, the certified VQX1 pod, onto the wing strut, ready to go without any bureaucratic certification process.
Wow, and as I just mentioned, that's quite a firework of news. So I see your development department has done a very good job. So Jürgen, Riegel will also be giving a presentation at this year's INTERGEO Conference. What is it about exactly?
Yeah, you're right. Riegel is giving a specific presentation on how BIM benefits from the Riegel technology. So our colleague and expert, Nikolaus Studnitzker, Business Division Manager for Terrestrial Laser Scanning, will give this presentation.
Wow, that's great. So right now we're absolutely up to date with what's new with Riegel at this year's INTERGEO. So you see many innovations and novelties at Riegel, really all very exciting. So if you want to see the whole interview, it's now in our channel INTERGEO TV on YouTube. And if you had followed INTERGEO Digital in 2020 live, so last year, you already know this young man. Lennart Preuss is part of the INTERGEO social media team. When he's not on Instagram, Facebook or Twitter, he's here visiting INTERGEO hybrid exhibitors on the platform. And today he is in our news edition. Hi Lennart and welcome.
Hello, Denise, and hello, INTERGEO. Yes, normally I'm the guy behind all the INTERGEO social media channels. But at INTERGEO Live and Digital, my job is slightly different. So I will visit exhibitors at their digital booths to show you how you can interact on the digital platform, like we all here interact at the INTERGEO hybrid here in Hannover. So if you want to be a part of our news show here together with Denise, don't hesitate and send me a digital message or even visit us here and the whole communication team in the corner of Hall 23. And back to you, Denise.
Great, Lennart. We are looking forward to your visits here to our exhibitors. And yeah, I guess this is your first live event in person, because last year you were at our INTERGEO EXPO lounge in the digital studio. So how do you feel? How is the mood, or how do you enjoy that?
It's definitely way more stressful for me, because last year we had this beautiful studio. It was warm and so many people, but it was just no pressure from the real exhibitors. And today you can see so much faces. It's such a cool atmosphere. Everyone is happy and putting the last things together here on the booths. And yeah, I'm a bit more nervous than last year, but I'm super happy to be here and be a part of INTERGEO.
Yeah, because actually what you cannot see, but what we can see is that we are here in Hall 23. And yeah, here are some visitors coming in, and this is really great to see that people are coming here in the exhibition halls.
Yes, I saw a few pictures of the entry, and it's really crowded there. There are a bunch of people waiting there, getting their tickets. And yes, I'm super hyped to see all the people here at the booths.
Great. So perfect to have you with us in our team here, Leonard, and we'll see you later at 1 p.m. Then we start with our first visits of INTERGEO Hybrid.
Yes. Thank you, Denise.
So thank you, Leonard. And we look forward to your live visits to INTERGEO Hybrid and in our upcoming news edition here on INTERGEO TV. And with innovations, highlights and word firsts, we're naturally also wanted to know what Hexagon in 2021 has in store. So of course, we're dying to know what are the main highlights for Hexagon at the show this year. Pascal Struppler is product manager at Hexagon Geosystems. He's passionate about new technologies to help people to do everyday things more efficiently and with more fun. So my colleague Günther Knappe met Pascal for an interview about Hexagon's main highlights.
Thanks, Denise. Pascal, that was quite a compliment. So fun and efficiency, that stands also for Hexagon Leica systems, I think, and the new products. You are launching new products at this show, INTERGEO in Hanover. Tell us about.
That's right. We're very excited to announce this year two new members to our BLK product family. It's the BLK ARC. ARC stands for Autonomous Reality Capture, and the BLK to Fly. And in combination with HXDR, Hexagon Digital Reality, we basically started with this new group, the age of autonomous reality capture.
You have a second product. One is the UAV, the other is a robot, as I saw before with you at your stand.
Right, so let's start with the robot. That's basically a Boston Dynamics spot. On there, you see our BLK ARC module. This is an autonomous LiDAR scanner module, and it helps basically the robot navigate. So we don't just capture the environment while the robot is moving through the environment. We also help the robot by providing him information about the local, about the localization, about its position, which is crucial for a system to be autonomous. And the second product, the BLK to Fly, you said a UAV. We tend to call it a flying laser scanner.
Okay.
Here we really got to a new level of easiness of use. So for us, this should be really an easy to use product that can be used by you, for example. I don't know if you have flown UAVs before, but you should not have fear from this product. You should be able to fly it. And the key for this is really full autonomy and full obstacle avoidance. And this is what we got with the BLK to Fly, which basically makes it autonomous and really easy to use. And of course, now if you have a flying laser scanner, you will reach places that you haven't reached before for reality capture. So roofs, facades, and due to the autonomous scanning, you will scan these facades basically with full coverage. So we will not have any scan shadows.
That sounds not only to be fun, that sounds very sophisticated. I think you have had a quite intelligent development to launch these products.
It is. So basically our core technology within both of these products, again, is our BLK Grand Slam technology. So this is a combination of LiDAR Slam and Visual Slam, and it helps the robots to basically solve this problem of simultaneously mapping. So we of course also use reality capture for that, but then also in the same time localizing the robot itself. This is the key problem, and once you solve this, you are basically free to teach the robot where to go. You can really come up with fancy algorithms to capture a building, for example. And you can go into places that are dangerous, for example, without having a human going there, of course.
I give you another keyword in this context, and it's XHDR.
Right.
Let's talk about this and about the possibility of creating a new digital reality, as you already mentioned.
Right, so HXDR is for us basically the second puzzle piece to this autonomous play, because the autonomous robots are just the first part, basically the data capture, mission planning data capture, but then also the data processing and the deliverable creation. We're also working to make this autonomous, and this is where HXDR comes in. We made a link from the devices to HXDR, so you have the possibility to directly upload data from the devices into the cloud. And once you've done that, autonomous processors will start in processing your data. Of course, you will get a point cloud, you will get textured meshes automatically. But then we're also working on creating direct deliverables. So the goal is really to have an end-to-end autonomous solution. Maybe in the future we don't need to work with point clouds anymore, but we right away get a direct scan versus BIM differences, for example. And this is really the goal of HXDR, to be this autonomous process in the cloud. And then, of course, once your data is in the cloud, it's very easy to visualize this. It's accessible from anywhere, so you just have to have a browser. You can access your data, you can visualize it. And of course, it's also very easy to share with your customers, with your work colleague, and to collaborate. So it's really this start autonomous capture to the end.
You are smiling. To sum it up, I think we can clearly say that with this new product, Hexagon Geosystem has reached a new level.
I would say so. And I think that's why I'm so passionate about it. It's really top-notch technology that we can work with. And of course, it creates whole new possibilities.
Thank you very much, Günther and Pascal Struppler from Hexagon Geosystems. This was the first issue of INTERGEO News. Updates, impressions from the opening and the conference are here at 1 p.m. But our program continues with interviews, so stay tuned. Günther Knappe meets Christiane Salbach from the organizer DVW. So have fun at INTERGEO 2021.